Hello, in this video I'm going to demonstrate the new Adrenaline 4.4.2 Sense 6 HTC One Max ROM.
I have a lot of pros for this ROM and a couple of cons, but one of the things that I really like about it is if you look here for my notification and my drop down, I can make everything translucent and I can also blur it, so I like that that look. If it's not like this, then each of these icons are in a solid black box and the little spaces in between these lines are the only thing that's translucent, so I thought it looked better to have the lines than black boxes. Another feature that we have here that is unique to this ROM is this bar up here. It actually has the slideable bar, and my wife has a Note 3 phone, and I actually was a little jealous about her little slider bar at the top because I hate having to open this, you know, and then tap that to have to get to these. So it's really awesome to have that, and then you can change the order, of course. So the order that I have them in are the ones I use the most, which is my high spot, my settings, my Wi-Fi, my airplane, my brightness, and of course another one that I use often, but there's only 5 spaces, is the Bluetooth. So right now I'm going back and forth about whether or not I want to switch out the hotspot and the Bluetooth, because I definitely use the Bluetooth more than I use the hotspot. But I haven't really made up my mind yet. Or even the bright... Oh, so what I want to do, I'm sorry. I'm going to take the brightness away here and move that down, because this is actually a brightness bar. That's another tweak in the Sense 6 Toolbox, which is an app that you can get from xposed installer, which comes built into the app. So I'm going to remove these brightness settings, and from here, as a matter of fact, I can just do it now, and you hit the pencil. This is how you alter it, and I'm gonna take it away, hit the bars and slide it down, and take it away here, and then when I go back, everything should be moved up. So let's look. Still there. I don't know why. Let's see what happened. Brightness, I moved it, so I moved it underneath these. Oh, I had to press done. So I pressed done. And now you see, airplane mode, Wi-Fi, settings, mobile hotspot, Bluetooth. So that's actually, I love that lineup. Those are the ones I use the most. The other thing I love is having my settings right here, because that's the easiest way to get to my settings. And then it's standard here. Now, one of the things I was using before I was using this ROM was the new Sense 6 ROM. And I really enjoyed that ROM because it was really pretty stable. And the one thing I really, really loved about it is that it had a font changer built into the ROM as well. So where you have the personalize here, and you could pick themes. Inside of the theme wasn't just these, inside of the personalize, it wasn't just these options here just for the alarm and notification. There was also, you could choose the font, and then you could choose what size font you wanted, and it would change it for the whole, phone. If you look at some of my other, videos, I have like, I had downloaded like 20 different fonts. I wanted to try them all. Font packs. So I had like 200 fonts, and I have bubble letters and some. And so I kind of, I missed that. I'm hoping that I can find a app that would allow me to change the system font so that I can have really funky font in my notifications and stuff like that. But of course the themes, these are the themes. I have the turquoise one here. When you choose them, it just gives you a check there on top of it. So that's something that's kind of, you know, funky with this, this ROM. And it's pretty much, you know, similar. Of course, when I installed it, I had to go into about and click the build number and get my USB debugging, like, you know, everything. It actually has the system updates. The new Sense 6 ROM did not, which means if I have any problems connecting to the internet, things like that, I can update my profile, update my PRL, and things of that nature, and not have to worry about changing to a stock ROM to do that, which I think is pretty cool to have that feature. But everything else is standard. The other thing with the new Sense 6 ROM is that the fingerprint scanner did not work on that ROM, but it works on this ROM. So you know, you just go continue, you tap what finger you want, tells you to swipe. Three more times. So far, I haven't been able to get it to actually do it. I can get it up to three times, and it doesn't actually save it. But I think that that's more a hardware malfunction than a software one. But I mean, when you it was there when you would click it, but when you would click it, nothing would happen. Whereas with this, it actually opens the application. So. The other thing is, of course, there's the Sense 6 toolbox, which has all the mods. I'm actually supposed to have pink icons up here. So you go to status bar. If you look, you can pick color theme. And as you can see, my color theme is pink here. So I don't know why they aren't pink. And you're supposed to basically restart the phone after you set all the settings, but I have the other ones like the volume bar and the transparency in the notifications, as well as the EQS, which this is the EQS here. So I mean, so that worked. The only one I see so far that didn't work was the changing of the highlights. There's also the HTC One tweaker, which gives you the voice call recording, which is pretty cool. I can demonstrate that really quickly. And right now I've decided to make this you know, my daily driver. So it makes the I tweaked it so I have a full screen. And see, if you click record here, it's off to the right. That's built in. That's a pretty funky feature, to be able to have that record in there. And then, of course, there's the system-wide tweaks. So you have the, oh yeah, this is another great feature that's built into the ROM, the allow SD card full access. So, of course, you have to turn that on, and then you can... your applications can write to your SD card. So before this, I couldn't even, all I could do was look. Before I turned it on, all I could do was look. But like, let's say I wanted to, you know, delete this or rename it, I couldn't do anything. It actually wouldn't allow me to do anything at all. But now, as you see, it works because I did that tweak. This isn't going to show you, but there's the blurred system UI here. That's right here. And then we have, that's what's allowing everything to be blurred. That was built into the ROM. The A-Logcat root, this app here. The mirror enabler, it's something that helps you mirror your phone to devices.
That was built in, and these are just kind of extras. The terminal emulator was built into the ROM. Wi-Fi calling, which I haven't figured out. YouTube add-away, a separate navigation from maps, which is pretty cool. I really would like to get places back to. This application called XSense, I haven't used it yet, but you turn that on with the xposed installer screen as well. Xposed installer application, which I'm looking for. I can't find it, so I'm just going to go ahead and type it in to find it. So this is xposed installer, and so of course I've been able to tweak and modify the phone. Like, I have the added reboot, so I have options. It doesn't just reboot. I have the hot reboot recovery and bootloader as an option because of the modules that I've downloaded. So these are all the modules that I've downloaded. I have the multi-window feature. I have the one-handed mode, which, you know, I don't use either one very often, but they are really handy to have. And the ROM it's fast, it's smooth, it utilizes my LTE, my 3G. As a matter of fact, I hardly ever get 3G. It holds on to the LTE really well. Wi-Fi, it hasn't been a problem connecting to Wi-Fi. So it uses the data. Everything that I've wanted to download, I've been able to download. It has some nice sound features inside of it. So, you know, let's go back to the settings and see what the sound profiles are like. So it's pretty much stock, but it has a few little extra things built in. Oh, the Beats audio is here, because that was another thing. In order for my Wi-Fi hotspot to work on my new Sense 6 ROM, I had to do a Wi-Fi fix, and that took away the Beats audio. I don't really care for the Beats audio. As you see, I have it off, as much as I like the music channel. I like playing my music and then being able to see the words. It's just something kind of fun and extra to have. But what was I doing? I was going into the settings to do the sound profiles. So here's the sound. I like some of the sounds that it has. Yeah, it's pretty funky. Some of these are the stock ringtones, but I like that. So that's pretty cool. And you can even download the gesture like the M8 has. There's a tweak for that with the kernel, but I wasn't interested in doing all of that. But I mean, it works. I mean, once I can call out on my phone and I can utilize my data, then the next things are stuff like Netflix. Netflix plays fine on this ROM, and of course it's whether or not it moves fast or easy. So the only thing that I'm missing from the other new Sense 6 ROM is being able to increase the size of my font. I'm not used to looking at it so small, and change the kind of font. Other than that, it's a really great, really cool ROM. I really like this Adrenaline ROM. It's based on Android 4.4.2 and 6 Sense. I can go ahead and show you that. Inside of software, so you see it's Android 4.4.2, HTC Sense 6.0. It has the same kernel that I've seen everybody using, as far as the kernel that it's using, which I didn't see that baseband kernel version, etc. So, I mean, it's pretty standard, but it's great. It's a great ROM. It has all the tweaks, and there's a lot of different 5.0 things that you can add to it that I wasn't interested in really adding to it right now. And the person who made this ROM, this is their first attempt at a ROM, so it's really great, because I know people who have made quite a few ROMs, and their ROMs are pretty bad. Wow. So I hope that this video helps someone. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.